Welcome to the project RF control three-phase starter for irrigation. For this project we have three-phase direct online starter, RPS segment, peak microcontroller, two relay circuits, RF transmitter and connected with switches and RF receiver. At first we have one step down transformer which will convert 230 volts of AC into 10 to 12 volts of AC. Now we have one bridge rectifier to convert AC into DC. After that capacitor and finally one voltage regulator to get constant 5 volts of DC supply to the microcontroller. Here we have a sliding switch. When we will switch it on, these two LEDs will blink and this one will glow. This shows that our RPS segment is working properly, and these two LEDs are blinking just to indicate that microcontroller has been initialized properly. For this project we have two processes. One is manual, another one is automatic. Manually, along with this starter, we have two buttons, red and green. We should place the red button to switch on our three-phase load. Here this is working as a three-phase load. Instead of this one, we can place anything according to our necessity. When we will press this green button, the starter is conducting and the load is getting power. When we will press the green red button, now the load is not getting any power. We can do the same thing automatically by using RF transmitter and RF receiver. In this RF receiver we have two switches. These are push buttons. One is to make the starter on and another one to make the starter off. Here we have a radio frequency transmitter. We are using 433.92 MHz of frequency and HT12V RF encoder. We can use 4-bit data transmission, but for our project we are using only 2 bits. So whatever be our data to be transmitted, encoder will encode it and it will transmit it by using this transmitter. Here we have RF receiver. We are using this particular receiver which will receive RF of the same frequency of 433.92 MHz. Both the transmitter and the receiver contains filters, so there is no necessity for connecting any external filter. Now we have HT12D decoder. This decoder IC will get input from RF receiver and it will decode it and send it to the microcontroller. When the microcontroller will get any signal, maybe it is on or off, it will take the respective action. So when we will press the on switch, this relay is getting activated. This relay coil is getting activated because this relay coil is connected to the microcontroller here. And this LED is also glowing just to indicate that my transmission is working properly. Here we have placed diodes just to make current to flow only from the microcontroller to the relay. The reverse flowing of the current will be opposed by these diodes. Now in this relay board we have BC547 NPN transistor. This transistor is working as a switch. So where my microcontroller will give supply to the relay coil, this transistor will be activated and this will allow the relay coil to be getting activated, and these two wires are connected to the starter to give supply. When we will press the off switch, this relay coil is getting activated. This relay coil is getting activated. Same like the before one, here also it is getting supply from the microcontroller. We have BC547 NPN transistor which is working as a switch. So when the transistor is in active mode, then only my relay coil will conduct and it will make the dual starter to be switched off. Now let us check the circuit internal circuit diagram of this particular starter. In this starter we have one red button and one green button. We are giving means we have RYB is red, yellow, blue connection along with one neutral, and in the output getting